day, viewers. Said back again. Before I move forward, I'd like to put up a disclaimer here. This video is for educational purpose, and I'll be doing this in my own lab environment. And I also want you to know that hacking is illegal, so do not use any of this information for malicious purposes. So having said that, I'll be taking you through a tool called Pyphisher. Okay, you just go to Google and you type Pyphisher. So choose this one with, how do I pronounce this, Cas Rodra. Just choose this one. So then you scroll down to a place like this. It's easy to install. Okay, those of you who don't know, I just go to this thing, you copy this this first command, you go to your terminal, you paste it. Okay, I already have it cloned, so I won't be using it. Then after that, you copy this one also, you also go to your terminal, you paste it, then you change directly to the Pyphisher directory. Then you run this command, pip install -r/files/requirements .tst. Okay, so it's going to put every requirement that you need for this thing to function very well. Okay, so once you've installed that, let me go to the this thing Pyphisher. CD to Pyphisher LS. So to run Pyphisher, we use a Python 3. So let's use a sudo Python 3 py Pyphisher. Okay, .py. You hit enter, you put your password, your sudo password. Okay, we'll let it load. Send, please wait. Okay, so what else I want to say is, as a pen tester, it is important to have a thorough understanding of different types of cyber attacks, including phishing attacks. So for those who don't know what phishing is a social engineering technique that involves tricking people into revealing sensitive information, such as login credentials, or by posing as a trustworthy entity. So, in the field of cyber security, for those who want to go find pen testing, sometimes an organization can hire you to try to break in through their employee. So, okay. Loaded. So since I'll be doing this in my lab, I'll use, do you have a local, or I'll use, no, do I have a NGO? So, but I'm doing this to myself. So okay, then it's going to pop up like this. So you can choose any one of your choice. Okay, anyone. So for this one, let me use a 46 for this this thing tutorial. Okay, you select the number you want, or use 46, or you can even use a 78 to costume the this thing, depending on the organization you've been testing for, go to their costume login page and you clone it. Okay, so I'll be using WordPress for this tutorial. So 46, enter shadow URL, blah blah blah, I don't need that. Okay, enter redirection. So this is, if you, once the person clicks, the employee clicks, put their credentials, and if you want it to redirect them somewhere else, okay, you can redirect them to their original page, or you can direct them somewhere. So maybe for this one, I'll just leave it like that. Okay, I'll just click enter. So it's generating my listing for me. Generating the URL for me. Okay, let me clear out these things. Okay, so we wait. So in pen testing, phishing technique can be used to stimulate reward attacks and identity vulnerabilities in organization security measure. So by crafting convincing phishing services, pen testers can test organizations, employees, awareness, and responsiveness to such attacks. Okay, still waiting for it to generate the link. Okay, so with phishing techniques, it can also be used to evaluate the effectiveness of technical security measures, such as spam filters and email authentication protocol. So, one fry costs 2 million. So, I'll be using this link here. This one is for my local network. So, I'm doing this in my home control environment. So, don't need this base. In an environment where you didn't have permission to do it. So I have permission to do this in my own lab. Okay, so take the website, the link, and go to your browser and let it know. Okay, so as you can see, this is exactly what first login. Okay, so let's say I put tests 1, 2, 3. Okay. Then maybe password, I'll put pass 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so I'll just click login. Then let's go to the let's go here and see. Okay, let's wait for it to populate here. Let me see. Please pardon me, my network is really slow. Okay. Try it again. See, log in. Let's go back. As you can see, this is the this thing, the username, and this is the password. Okay, if this is an organization, the employee already submitted their data. Okay, so the phishing attack is successful. So please use this information for legal purposes. I will not be held responsible for any act of illegality you use if you dare use this information. So I think it's legal in most countries. All right, stay safe. Thank you. Peace out.